Should you niche before you get started accepting bookkeeping clients? Guys, today I'm going to talk all about whether I made a niche in bookkeeping before I started accepting my clients, before I started interviewing, as I started to advertise my business. If you hear my daughter in the background, she is having a terrible time teething and just cannot help playing with some toys. Thank you so much for coming to my channel and checking out my videos. Sorry if it's a distraction, but a 4-month-old and a 2-year-old are definitely my reality. Here's the bottom line. Did I niche? No. The short answer is not even a little bit. If you could consider my niche at first, it was landscaping because that's what my husband does. And technically, he is my first client. And I do think that I really would enjoy working with other landscapers, especially because there is some added value to knowing a company and what type of transactions they're gonna have and run into. It's helpful to you as a bookkeeper to have your bearings straight about what a business is going to be doing and what type of transactions they're gonna be making. But I do think that there's a learning curve with any company and any business. And so even if you niche down and only accept landscaping clients or only accept dentistry clients, then there is gonna be a period of getting to know their company and how they do their records. So do I have a niche? No. Do I have a preferred client because of my prior experience? Yes. Will I accept anyone? Absolutely. I'm also gonna put in a word here that I do think it's helpful to niche eventually. However, in the beginning, you shouldn't be picky. It's also important to think about your location, right? So I'm in a rural setting, and so construction and agriculture and landscaping are things that are right within my realm, right within arm's reach. There are definitely other businesses in my community. There are small businesses of jewelry makers, artisans. There's an artisan collective in our county, in our community. There are babysitters and daycares. There are lawyer offices and such. But I think that if you were in a city, maybe some of the things that I just described wouldn't be in arm's reach. The other thing that you can take into account is whether you are virtually bookkeeping or not. I have reached out on Facebook to lots of different businesses and small business owners that do a wide variety of things, including online boutique sales, and other small niches that you might not find within your area, but virtually you could reach out to. Take into account what you may have direct experience with, and that's not just from a bookkeeping angle, but from a consumer or a customer angle. I would love, absolutely love, to do bookkeeping for a birth center because I worked for a long time as a client or a customer of a birth center. I had both of my children at a very small practice of midwives, and I know the type of things that they are going to have transactions and records in their business for. So they're going to have different record keeping or different types of transactions than if I went and was a bookkeeper for an OBGYN. There are a lot of different things that you can pull from of your experience just being in the marketplace that you could bring to the table as a bookkeeper instead of from a customer perspective. You kind of want to think about that as you speaking their language. You know about their business, you know some of the ins and outs, and that's what you can bring to the table. If you decide that you kind of want to niche, so you're starting out, so you don't want to turn away customers, I think that that's important that you maybe move in a direction, you start to advertise and reach out to very specific clients, but that you kind of advertise overall so that you could bring in lots of different clients. Even just meeting with a client that has a business that isn't within your specified niche, you can still learn a lot about how to talk and interview with a client, what things a client might want you to do in their business as their bookkeeper. All of those experiences, even if it doesn't end up in a full a client relationship and them paying you to be their bookkeeper, you're gonna learn so much just by talking to business owners. And I think that that's really important. So don't turn away or neglect experience that could come from multiple different business types. Another idea here about niching is that you could potentially, while you're starting and growing your business, work under another bookkeeper. Maybe that's trying to outsource some of their smaller tasks or business bookkeeping tasks that they don't have time for. Or you could work for a CPA, and this would give you lots of experience in many different fields, or specifically in a niche that someone else has. And that would give you an opportunity to say, do I like working with that niche? Or do I like working with these two different types of businesses? Or what do I prefer? And where are my strengths? Don't be afraid to reach out for help from someone who's already established in order to get yourself established and experienced with different types of customers and clients than you might be right now. So my last final word about niching is that sure, if you want to niche, you go for it, but I don't think that you have to. And really the drive behind making this video is that when you're first becoming a bookkeeper and you start to watch lots of videos and read lots of blogs, it's one of their top 5 tips for becoming a bookkeeper is that you should niche. And I'm not saying that they're lying to you, but I don't know if it's all that realistic to niche from the very beginning. I haven't done bookkeeper launch. I haven't done programs by other women, respected women that have bookkeeping businesses and training, but I'm just talking from a real 100%. This is me doing my bookkeeping business. I haven't niched and I don't plan on it anytime soon. If you have any questions about how I started my bookkeeping business, make sure to watch the playlist from week 1 to week 6 of how I created my business. As I learn new things and I go along, I'm gonna create videos all along my journey. And so hopefully this will help you in creating your bookkeeping business. Thanks so much. Leave me a comment, hit subscribe, and we'll see you next time.